this is a quick look at the 4-port universal heater that I've just bought from eBay to fit to my Austin 10. My car never had a heater fitted as standard, so I thought I'll just get anyone that's a decent enough size to fit under the dashboard where I can hide it. It's got an A-series engine, so I'm able to connect it up simply enough. I couldn't use a Morris Minor heater or a mini heater because they're just too big to fit in the space. But anyway, that's what you get. It's got a long drum fan in it, 75 quid. It's quiet enough when you spin it up. A bag of Jubilee clips and some fittings for it. Some sort of hose extenders, adapters. They're 16mm or 5/8. The switch that I got with it didn't have a heatsink on the back. It burned out very, very quickly. So I couldn't be bothered sending it back and complaining. So I just bought another one from eBay, but a better one with a heatsink on it. So I'm going to stick that on the side with a bit of double-sided tape. You don't get instructions to wire them, but the instructions are blue or green goes to the motor negative wire. The red goes to the motor positive and the positive from your power supply. And the black goes to your negative power supply. So I now have to drill some holes to mount this in place, line up the holes in the bulkhead to get these fittings on. And I've made up some reducers so I can reduce the 5/8 to 1/2 inch to fit the Morris Minor fittings. I'll put this Morris Minor brass tap there. It's not the lever type, so I don't want to drill any more holes in the dashboard. There are more than enough already. I'll drill another hole there in the bulkhead just to feed the pipes through. I'll put a grommet around that, stopping it shaking when the engine vibrates back and forwards. And Morris Minor hose. I might get a different one actually, the one that goes this side, to make it a bit neater. But anyway, at the moment I can't make this any neater than it is already. It's a bit of a mess. Well, I could tidy up the wiring, that's what I mean. But yeah, the engine's been running for 10 minutes, 20 minutes. Let's see how the heater actually functions. Well, it has tucked quite neatly under there. It's out the way of feet. I guess I could have stuffed it up there, pushed it back a bit further, but then it might catch the shins. But that's in there. Blow out kind of warm air, but the matrix itself seems to be made from this size tubing, so it's not very efficient. Put the heater on the fan on full blast. On full blast, it just cools it down too much. The matrix isn't giving its heat up very readily. Quarter, and the engine's not up to running temperature yet, but yeah, on a quarter it throws out a nice bit of heat, and I can put these little ducts on and zip tie these neatly up out the way to direct the air for driver's feet, driver's face, etc. But yeah, for what you pay, I'm pretty happy with that.